Okay, my little video tonight is going to be on this Nikon 5200 compact camera. The camera used to work fine, apart from the fact that it's got a broken door. But normally I just tape that up. The camera's worked fine ever since I've had it, but all of a sudden it started giving me a card can't be used message. So there is a card in it, but then this card is actually works fine in another camera. But I've been looking down inside there, and you can, if you have a look, I'm not sure if you'll be able to see or not, but it looks like, no, you probably won't be able to see, but it looks to me like there's might be a bent pin down there. So what I'm going to do is take the thing apart, and if it has got a bent pin, hopefully straighten it out and get the camera working again. So it's only an old camera, so I mean, I'm not particularly bothered if it, you know, I destroy it. I don't really want to, but if I do, it won't be any great loss, I don't suppose. The camera's in pretty good condition, really. It hasn't had heavy use. Zoom you in a bit. Not sure if this bit's aluminium or plastic. I think it's just silver coated plastic, to be honest. I remember when I bought this camera, I think probably about 3 or 4 years ago maybe. I think it was something like, at the time, I think it was £250, £300. So it was by no means a, you know, a cheap and nasty one. But I've got another one now, so I tend to use that all the time. See how close I can get you in without distorting. It should be okay. I'm just taking everything off this side. Taking the screws out. The card slot is on the this side here, so I want to get under this area. Screen off. Right. Okay, it looks like four ribbon type cables. One here. Another one there. Use this little dental type pick thing for jobs like this. It's really good. I think I got them in a little a pack of about six of them from eBay. You get all different tips, you know, different shaped tips, and you get ones with points and things like that, and they're really, really handy for little jobs like this. And then there's another one there. This board's actually got different connectors on it. Some of them are the push tab type where the cable's actually inserted, and some of them are like this one that just pushes down. And the cable, I think, pops out. Alright, it does slide in a bit. I'll just wait till I move the board before I start pulling at that. Okay, so it looks like this board's actually split here. Hopefully I won't have to take that bit out, because that looks like the could be the lens driver, I would imagine. Yeah, so let's see if I can just take this section out. Although we've got a soldered joint somewhere here and here. Not a very good one either. Okay. Right. Let's see if I can pop this board up now. Tight. It's the tripod mount. Just slides in, yeah. And there's screws under here too. Wires. Okay. I don't know what those things are, little tiny maybe earthing points, something like that. I don't want to snap this thing up in case I start breaking parts. That would not be good. Okay. So I think I'm gonna have to desolder that, I think. Clean that up a little tiny bit. I'm just going to solder suck this little blob up. Really what I would call a factory solder joint there. You can actually see it's still got some of the flux resin, or there's flux residue left around the joint. It's a bit, maybe an afterthought, that wire, I would imagine. Don't see why they couldn't have routed through to that board via one of the ribbons. And there's the card slot. And that's the, you can just see there, I'll try and zoom in a tad more. If you look here, you can see one of the joints is the contacts has budged right across. These are all straight, and this one's pushed sideways. So possibly that's one. That's the one that's. Well, it's highly likely that that's the one that's not been making contact. So I'll bend that one back. I'll just take. I may as well take these wires off now, because I don't really want to break any. See that one just. Looks better. And I'll try the card in. Still plenty of tension on them, so I think they should be. be fine. I mean, I don't know if that's got bent in the first place. Unless something's been, you know, got stuck in there, or the camera's been put in a cupboard or something with the door open and something's poked itself in there. Anyway, bung it back together and see what happens. Solder this little tiny wire back on. I don't need any more solder, because there's enough on the joint and on the wire. Next looks like this one. The trick with these things is not just these ribbon cables, the whole job really. The trick is to remember the sequence in which everything comes apart, because sometimes you find yourself putting things back together then taking things apart again so you can put, you know, something else in first. So if you've got a little sequence going in your mind, it makes everything a lot easier. It's sometimes hard to do though. If it's quite a substantial job where there's lots of parts like this, sometimes I actually write down a little sequence on a piece of paper. Helps me to remember where everything goes and in what order. Works. Battery's in, the door's still broken obviously. Cards in. And yep. Seeing how many pictures we've got left, so see there? Yep. ATA pictures, that's more than it would be on internal memory, so that card seems to be working. No. Yeah, the camera will only store 4. On internal memory. Yep, 88. There we go. One fixed. Coolpix 5200. Well, apart from the fact I'm going to have to put a little bit of Captain tape on there. But other than that, that's a working camera. Thanks for watching.